Dear grade 12s, physical sciences, we are starting with vertical projectiles. Let's continue the vertical projectiles. So we are going to study the motion of these projectiles when they are either going up or going down. So in this case, now we need our pre-knowledge, what we learned in the previous grades. Our pre-knowledge, very important, because we should not build from a vacuum. In this case now, in somewhere in grade 10 and 11, you learned about vectors, that vectors are physical quantities with magnitude or size and direction. Very important, direction. In this case, again, we learned about the so-called reference point. Reference point meaning that now anytime when you want to entertain motion, you must have the reference point, your starting point and the final point. That is very important. We learned about position of objects as well. We learned about displacement of objects in this case. So we'll deal with the word position and the displacement here. Displacement, fine, and together with distance as well, no problem. We learned about acceleration and velocity. Don't forget that velocity and acceleration. You see, remember the definitions, that velocity is the rate of change of position, whereas acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. That's how we know this one from the lower grades. We learned about also the description of motion, that motion might be accelerating, motion might be moving at constant velocity, or might be constant, or motion might be undergoing the decrease in velocity or increase in velocity. So types of motion, very important. Again, the important aspects that you need to know, especially when coming to graphs. I think somewhere also we learned about graphs in the lower grades. Now, graphs of motion. That if I've got a displacement time graph, a displacement time graph or position time graph. Now, this is a position time graph. And if this is the case, the slope of this line, slope of this line, which is your delta y over delta x, therefore this will represent, according to this one, velocity. Yeah, so meaning that if the slope is constant like this, then it means that the velocity is constant. If the slope might be increasing, then the velocity is increasing. The slope decreasing, the velocity is decreasing. Think also take note of that one. Again, we learned in a velocity time graph again about the slope issue, velocity time graph. That if I've got a straight line here in a velocity time graph, again, the slope of this line, which is your delta V, over delta t, represent acceleration. So meaning that now if the slope is constant like this, therefore acceleration is constant. Very important with the section that we'll be dealing with, because acceleration will be constant throughout. Therefore, in all the time when you draw the velocity time graph, we are going to draw a straight line. I hope you are listening properly. To say all the time when you draw a velocity time graph in this section of projectile, we'll be drawing a straight line. So that's the case. Now, from this, again in a velocity time graph, we learned that the area under graph, the area under this graph, area under the graph, your half base times height will represent displacement or distance. Displacement or distance, very important, because somewhere somehow they can calculate how far. So using the graph, then you can always determine that using the graph. Very important pre-knowledge that we need to know when dealing with this section. Okay, now in the section of projectiles, we'll be dealing with free-falling objects. Free-falling objects, we should refer them as projectile. This projectile, according to, in a nutshell, they will be mainly moving at constant acceleration. Constant acceleration at any given time. At any given time. Given time. Meaning that whether they are going up or whether they are going down or whether they are at the maximum point, then meaning that if this is the projectile at any given point, at this point A, at this point B, at this point C, in all these cases, the projectile will be having the same acceleration, which is G, and this G is called gravitational acceleration, which is equivalent to 9.8 meters per second squared downwards. So at any given point, the projectile will be accelerating at 9.8 meters per second squared downwards. That is why we say this projectile now will be falling freely, because this will only be achieved when air resistance is ignored. When the air resistance is ignored. Air resistance is ignored. In a nutshell, if you don't know when air resistance is not, you can just quickly to say when the object is going up, if you draw a free body diagram, it will experience the weight and also will experience the air friction. When the object is going down, will experience again, this is when the object is going up. When the object is coming down, it will be experiencing the weight. The weight is always down and the friction will be upwards. Now, if we ignore the air resistance, meaning that now this F falls off, air falls off. That's why now we say when the object is falling freely, is in the absence of air friction. And in this case, the only force acting on the projectile is the weight now, the gravity. So that is why now we call it a projectile, when the only force acting on that projectile is the gravitational force. That is the case here. Now let's come to the equations of motion. I hope you learned about equations of motion in grade 10. Equations of motion. Because motion started in grade 10. Equations of motion. There are four in number. The first one is Vf equals to Vi plus A delta T. The second one is Vf squared equals to Vi squared plus 2a delta y. The third one is delta y equals to vi delta t. The next equation is delta y equals to vi delta t plus half a delta t squared. The last one is delta y equals to vi plus vf divided by 2 all multiplied by delta t. Very important in the equations of motion is that they all have got five quantities that are involved here. So which means that is a VI, there's a VF, there's a A, and there is a delta T, and there's delta Y. I hope you are familiar with this, because VI is the initial velocity, VF final velocity, A acceleration, which is constant in this case. So we'll either have positive 9.8 or negative 9.8, depending on our choice and the direction of motion. Delta T is the only scalar in all these five quantities, and delta Y. So therefore, VI, VF, A, delta Y, they are all vectors. We talked about vectors earlier. So that's the case. Now, they are all five. But what you should know is that all equations of any equation of motion consist of four quantities. Four quantities now. So, meaning that now each one has got four. Mathematically, if you want to use one, you need to know minimum three quantities. That is how we'll be dealing with this one. Now, in terms of units, we know that velocity is measured, initial velocity and the final velocity are measured in meters per second. Meters per second, acceleration is meters per second squared, time is seconds, and the delta y is in meters. It's a displacement. Now, what you should know in this one, which is very important again, is that all these equations of motion, all the four equations of motion, they've got one variable that appears in all of them. If you have not noted, all of them have got VI. All of them have got VI. Therefore, it means that now there is no way that you can deal with equations of motion without VI. Therefore, it's either you are given the value of VI or you have to calculate it. That's the only two conditions. So, because you can't do away with the VI. Therefore, of all the five, we know that one should be there in all of them. Now, and this VI will also help us in determining the direction of motion. Therefore, how do you determine the direction of motion? We are guided by the VI. Therefore, if the VI, the initial velocity, if the initial velocity start by going up, will take upward as positive. And the moment upward is positive, immediately you must know that A will be negative 9.8, because A, naturally, the acceleration is always downwards. Now, therefore, if upward is positive, mean that downward is negative. That's why it will be negative 9.8. Then if the initial velocity of the projectile, the initial motion of the projectile, is start by going downwards, you are doing this to avoid confusion. Therefore, take downward as positive. Therefore, A will become positive 9.8. I hope that one is clear in this case. So we'll see the implementation of these equations in the next part. Thank you.